Hello and welcome to Digital Goulash. My name is Chucky and today I'm going to take you through how to really make a cartoon in Photoshop Elements. Now I've looked over some of the previous tutorials on other sites and I didn't really like the way they looked all too much, so I created one of my own, and this is the effect that I got right here. We have this look. It does look like it is a cartoon or a comic book. So I've taken the Code Poets picture. This is the one that he lets me use through the Creative Commons license. And let's go ahead and revert this image. But before we do so, let's look at the different layers that I have here. I have the yellow and kind of an orangish background layer here. I've got two layers of the Code Poets picture here, and then I've got some lines on top of that. So let's go ahead and let's revert this image by going to Edit and then Revert. And it takes us back to the original image here. Now what I want to do right off the bat is unlock this layer by double-clicking on the background and selecting OK, and that gives me this layer. Now the next thing I want to do is I want to use one of the filters by going over to Filter. Now you can look at the different filters by going to Filter Gallery here. This will show you all the different filters that are available. Now I like the one that says Poster Edge, and then you can change the thickness, edge intensity, and posterization to however you like it. Now I've been playing with this and this is really the one that I like here, so I'm going to leave it as is and select OK, and then it's going to make that poster look here, which is kind of like the comic book effect as well. Now what I want to do is I want to duplicate this layer because it looks like a comic, but we're going to make it look a little bit more like a comic. Now Command J or Control J on the PC will duplicate the layer, and as you can see over here, layer 0 copy. So we have a copy of that. The next thing I want to do is I want to create some halftoning. Halftoning, what it does is kind of gives it that comic book effect, the real comic book effect. And if you look under Pixelate, we have Color Halftone. Now we have different radiuses, which we can start at 4 and we can go all the way up to 8. Maybe a little bit more, but I chose 4 just to leave it as is, and then all these different channels I haven't really played with, so I'm going to leave them as is as well. So the only one I changed was this max radius. It was on 8, I put it on 4. I'm going to select OK here. Now that really doesn't look that good, but we do have some nice halftoning going on here. It looks like it's about to be printed in comic book fashion. Now I'm going to go to my layers menu, the blending modes, and I want to pick on this one, I want to pick color. And I want to show you what this one looks like. Kind of has a nice comic book effect. So if you like the comic book effect, you can use color. If you want to give it kind of a dark foreboding look to it, you can come up here and you can choose multiply. And that one looks a little bit different than the other one. So either or, if you want to have one that looks comic booky, you can choose color, and if you want a little bit more dark and foreboding, you can go over here and choose multiply. Now I'm going to leave this as is right now, these two. I'm going to leave it on multiply, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to increase the size of the canvas. So I'm going to go to resize canvas. Now the reason I'm going to do that is because we want to put something behind this. I've checked relative, and then I'm going to add about, let's say, an inch on each side of this photo image and select OK. And you can see what happens is it put a transparency all around about an inch. So it gives us the what's starting to look like more of a comic book effect. Now, I'm on layer 0. If I hold the Command or Control key while I click the new layer icon, it will add a layer beneath, and that's what I want to have right now, because we're going to add a gradient. Here's the gradient tool right here. Click on gradient tool, and then we're going to check a or pick a foreground and a background color. So if I double click on the white, I like the yellows because they have that comic book effect, so I'm going to pick a nice bright yellow here, and then I'm going to double click on the black. I'm going to pick on a little bit more of an orangey color here, and I'm going to select OK. So now we have yellow to orange. If you don't see them, click the down arrow here and it should be the very first one there. And then I'm going to start on this corner, making sure that I have layer 1 selected. going to start in this corner, and then I'm going to go all the way to the other corner, and there we go. We have, now it's really starting to look like a comic. Now, I want to go to the layer 0 copy. I know it seems like it's a lot of steps, but it really isn't. I'm going to create a new layer. This time, I'm not going to hold down the control or the command key because I want to add a layer on top of this. What we're going to do is we're going to add a black line around this picture. So what I need to do is I need to hold the command key down while I click on this particular picture. And you notice what happens is the marching ants attach to the outside of the picture frame, which is what we want. But make sure that you're on layer 2, because we're going to add a stroke to this. So if we go to Edit, and we go to Stroke right here, I'm going to stroke this 10 pixels to the inside, but we don't want to stroke it with yellow. We want to stroke it with black, and black is 0, 0, 0. Select OK, and OK once again. And as you can see, it stroked this layer black. Now what we want to do is we want to add a little bit of a box right here where we can add some text. So I'm going to hit the Command D to make the marching ants go away. I'm going to select the Marquee tool again. I'm going to go to this corner right here, and I'm going to select this right corner right there. Now I want to line this up really well, and I'm going to add another stroke by going to Edit, Stroke. Now all of our parameters should already be in there, so I'm going to select OK, and then Command D to get rid of the ants. Now there is our new little label right down here for our caption. What we're going to do is we're going to either hit D on the keyboard, and that will make a black and white here, or you can click this little icon right down here. Now you're going to select the X key to swap these two, and we're going to choose the paint bucket tool, and we're going to fill this paint bucket with white. So this is where you would add your caption right in here. You can download some fonts, some comic book fonts. Just do a Google search for comic book fonts, and then you can add some comic book fonts right there. What I'm really interested in now is just having you look at the comic book effect right here. Now, this is a little bit too straight or too crisp for me, so I'm going to select the smudge tool. Now, the smudge tool may be a little bit different on yours because you might have the blur or sharpen tool up, so I'm going to hit the smudge tool right there, and then I'm going to make sure that my brush size is fairly large. You can use the left and right bracket key here to do that. Making sure I'm on layer 2, I'm going to select, and I'm going to just sit here and kind of smudge this sharpness away a little bit. Just giving it the pencil drawn effect here. Just kind of look like it's been hand drawn. There we go. Just every so often, just kind of do a little bit of a smudge here. And we get that nice drawn look here. So now it looks like there is our comic right here. We've created, from our beginning, we created a layer. We duplicated that layer, and we used two filters on this one. We used the poster edge, and we use the half toning. We added a gradient underneath here, usually a very vibrant color like a yellow, and then we added the black lines as a layer above. So hopefully you had fun with this. Turn yourself into a comic book. If you haven't done so already, please subscribe to my videos. Give me a couple thumbs up. If you want to, leave a comment and I'll try to get back to you. Cheers!